pretty good deal there, but what's the deal in the weather department? What are we expecting today, Ms. Maxwell?
Well, we are going to be expecting a little bit of a switch. I mean, right now we're already seeing temperatures a little bit cooler over the area than what we have been used to seeing. Dry to start, but the rain is going to creep in for us, starting to already for a few areas, but majority of it will come in for us during the afternoon. Right now we are holding into the lower and the middle 30s over the area. A few places are fluctuating into the upper 20s. Calm conditions for us to start, but as we head into the afternoon and this evening, we'll see those winds really pick up in speed. Here's a look at 7:30 p.m. tonight. Already seeing wind gusts try to pick up to about 30 miles per hour. Tomorrow morning when that front comes through, very windy conditions will be on top. Going to be around 45 miles per hour for a few spots. So with that in mind, could deal with some power outages starting tonight, lingering throughout tomorrow and potentially even into Friday. Wind gusts look to be heading around 35 to 45 miles per hour. So along with power outages, could see some downed trees, especially where the soil is already so saturated. I mean, we are starting off dry, looking at our Beckley Live weather camera, not really dealing with the rain showers quite yet. A little bit of showers are trying to pick up, especially into the upper levels. Majority of rain, though, is going to come all because of the system down to our southwest is going to glide in, dealing with some heavier downpours down to our south. We'll get a little bit of that, too, especially into this evening and tomorrow morning. Here's a look at our Wednesday planner. Highs will only be into the middle and the upper 40s. Very windy day on tap, especially starting the afternoon. We do see rain showers pick up, though, more widespread afternoon and throughout the evening for us. The excessive rainfall outlook does have a slight risk for portions of our western slopes, really confined over the majority of Buchanan County. Most of us, though, dealing with a marginal risk for excessive rainfall today. Flash flood watch is issued. So this is a flash flood watch. Yesterday, it was an aerial flood watch. It has upgraded. Flash flooding means that it's going to occur much more quickly than what aerial flooding will be. So it could be rapid. Pocahontas County, Fayette, Raleigh, Wyoming, McDowell, and Buchanan counties will be under this flash flood watch starting at 4 p.m. and lasting until 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. The RPM model is showing that we're going to be picking up on about half an inch, upwards to an inch for some isolated spots throughout this evening and throughout tomorrow. We're dry to start for most of the area. Showers will build in this afternoon, widespread throughout the evening with those heavy downpours. Looks like we'll have on and off showers overnight tonight, but look at tomorrow morning. The morning commute is going to be a soaker. We will be having those heavy downpours at times. High temperatures will start us off in the morning. As we notice, we'll start to see showers become more spotty. We start to be cooler throughout the course of tomorrow. So that's going to allow us to see a transition from rain into a little bit of some light snowfall that will linger into Friday morning. Not talking about big totals by any means, only going to be seen for most of the area, really nothing. Could have some trace amounts try to pick up for a few spots. Here's a look at the extended forecast to show that we do have flooding possible starting today, lingering throughout tomorrow. A little bit of light snowfall will come our way Thursday night, leading us into Friday morning. By Friday afternoon, though, we should actually be mostly dry, but check out how much cooler we will be. Only having the highs into the 20s, lows dipping down into the teens.